Here's an aerial view of one of the largest shell ring complexes on the southeastern Atlantic coast. It's the Fig Island Shell Ring Complex in South Carolina. There's a very large feature, which is actually a crescent-shaped feature. You then cross over to the marsh, and there's an octagon-shaped feature, and then a crescent-shaped feature. And that's how these complexes usually are. There's usually several of them, usually a circle and a crescent. About 4 years ago, archaeologists spent a good deal of time mapping the features that you just saw from the air. And you see that there's a large kind of semicircle here with what's been interpreted as an amphitheater. Lots of little secondary rings or ringlets coming off of it. Across the marsh, the octagon with the opening, and then the crescent over here. And through probing, we know that these two are actually connected, and sea level rise has inundated the ramp that connected those two features. This shows one artist rendition of a shell ring, how it might have looked. And all around the world, prehistoric societies live in semicircles or circular kind of villages. And here's kind of a semicircle of houses. The shell refuse, the garbage of everyday life, animal carcasses and broken pieces of pottery and soapstone slabs are discarded along with all the shellfish remains. And then there's a conscious effort or an organizational effort to manipulate them into these geometric constructs we see today, horseshoes and crescents and circles and mounds. Now we'll head off and have a look at these features from ground level. All right, that's the octagon feature. So there's three features. We call this one. Mm-hmm. And then the octagon is two and the crescent is three. Yeah. We're on top of the largest of the three shell features here. And behind me, you can see it's sloping down. And this is interpreted perhaps as an amphitheater, where various activities would take place down below here, and folks would be sitting around on the edge of here. Now, this is a lot smaller than the next feature that we will visit. And perhaps this was a higher status group that wanted to sequester themselves away from the larger part of the society and hold special events here. The one we're gonna go to is a more open kind of area that would have greater participation. All right, we're gonna walk over. This is all shell midden, and shell midden is the shells that we saw at the other one, plus there's in all these. Animal bones are well preserved in here. The shell changes the pH of the soil, and we get really good preservation of the fishes, birds, and mammals that they're extracting out of the environment for food. If they were without this shell, we wouldn't get that preservation. So the current idea on these is that these are special function sites. They have a ceremonial nature to them, and people come and live here for a certain amount of time, so you get that habitation build up, but that these are some kind of special sites. And looking around the world ethnographically, when we see tribal level societies, they often live in circles and in crescents and horseshoe shaped villages. And the higher up you are, you see there's different elevations on this shell feature, the higher up you are, the higher your status is in society. These folks are kind of trans-egalitarian. They are moving from an egalitarian society to a tribal society. And at times, the leaders may have called people together for aggregations where ceremonies would take place, perhaps weddings, burials, and other rites of passage, initiations may have taken place with the larger group. And then they disperse across the land for the rest of the year, or at certain times come back to this ceremonial place. Now we're gonna go and visit the third and final of the shell features here, and we're gonna move from the octagon to the crescent. So we'll head over here and we'll walk the ramp for fun. Okay. Right through here is a trench that was excavated, and we started on the far side and then excavated all the way through this. And the idea was we wanted to get a look at what is the makeup of this, how did the inhabitants of this site create this. We also wanted to get from the very top, select some oyster shells for carbon dating. We also wanted to get one from the very bottom to get a feel for how fast were these things built. And the dates from the bottom and the top hover very close together, so it tells us that these were erected fairly quickly over a period of a couple hundred years. In many ways, we have a wonderful cultural site here from 4,000 years ago. We have an ecological time capsule as well, because we have that animal bone, we know it's in the environment, and also preserved in the soil here is plant remains. If they're carbonized seeds from the fires of the plants they're using for food, they're also preserved here. So we get our cultural history, our archaeology, and we get our animals as well as our plants all here at one place.